Now class 9, the Sangam Age. This is the last part of the chapter, but then I will give you question answer in my next day. Now today, page 63, the economic conditions. The economic conditions. The Sangam literature gives a true and complete picture of economic conditions as well. All the information we are getting from the sources of history, either from the literature or from the archaeological sources of history. Now, from the literature, from the literary source, we come to know about the economic conditions. Agriculture. Agriculture was the main occupation of a large section of the people. Land was held by individuals as well as by the state. Land was held by the individuals as well as by the state. The land was fertile and there was plenty of grain, meat and fish. The land was fertile and there was plenty of grain, meat and fish. The Chola country was watered by the river Kaveri. Chola country was watered by the river Kaveri. The Chera region was well known for its buffaloes, jackfruit, pepper and turmeric. The rich did not plow the land themselves. They hired laborers called pariyars for this job. The rich did not plow the land for themselves. They hired laborers, and the laborers are called the pariyars for this job. The pariyars belong to the lowest social class and skin dead animals also. Now, they skin dead animals also. Trade. The rulers had big income from trade transactions also. A large number of crafts and occupations are referred to in the Sangam literature. The epic Manimekalai was written by a grain merchant of Madurai. The Tamil literature refers to items of trade like spices, sandalwood, pearls, sea products, semi-precious stones, and textiles of various types. We also have the information that foreigners visited the coastal towns for trade. Metal lumps in different shapes and bottles of wine figure prominently among the articles of trade brought to India by the foreigners. Now, this is about the trade, and many Roman traders resided in South India on those days. The ports of Noura and Nilanda were among the most prominent ports in Indian Western Coast. Listen carefully, my students, note the spelling. The Westerners were very, very much fond of Indian people. It therefore began to be called Javanpriya in Sanskrit. It is called as Yavanpriya. Roman coins of gold and silver found in southern peninsula suggest that Indo-Roman trade brought great gains to Indian merchants. Trade brought great gains to Indian merchants. Other occupations. Among other prominent occupations, mention may be made of spinning and weaving, metalwork, ornament making, ivory being used for making curved ornaments and other objects. According to some poets, the cotton dress was so smooth and shiny that it looked as if made of a snake's skin. Shipbuilding was another prominent occupation that provided livelihood to many artisans. Now, then occupational guilds, very important. Guilds, what is guilds? Guilds had become an important institution in the economy of the Sangam Age. The guilds define rules of work and control the quality and prices of the finished products. The guilds also functioned as bankers and financiers. Guilds also carried out welfare activities and services of mankind. Then socio-economic inequalities. In Sangam Age, sharp social difficulties. Now, in Sangam Age, the sharp socioeconomic inequalities. The rich lived in houses made of brick and mortar, where the poor lived in small mud-walled house. So there was a great difference in between the rich and the poor. The Sangam poets gave descriptions of the hunters' huts full of bows and shields, shepherds' houses where curds and butter were produced for and the living conditions of the learned for selling and for living condition of the learned Brahmins and the rich merchants. We notice the splendor of the large grand buildings which belong to kings and members of the ruling class. The royal priest also lived in grand structures. That is up till this, my students, the chapter complete. Next day, question answer, both from your book, and I explain vividly from your book, from your textbook. Okay? Okay. Thank you very much.